What's True TV's big mechanism for getting content out from the website into social channels, and how do you increase engagement through that?
Right, well, one of the important things we try to do is to get the personalities of our talent, the stars of our shows, out via social media. To create a True TV individual one-hour show might cost as much as, say, $250,000. But using social, we can get video, commentary, photos, pretty much a lot of different things from our talent out on a daily basis at a fraction of the cost. So we're selling our personalities without having to pay the high cost of producing a television series.
So would you say that social marketing, in a sense, is really, like, for your customer acquisition costs, it's really saving you a lot of money?
Oh, yeah. I mean, traditionally, if we wanted to get the stars of our shows out, we might use PR to try to get on the Jay Leno show or talk shows. And while we still try to do that, on social media, I kind of like to think that we're covering our talent in a way that the news media might if they were really interested. So we'll do daily updates on what our talent are doing, interviews with them, as much information as we can to sell them and therefore get people interested in who our talent are.
And I guess the follow-up to that is, you know, so you have social engagement that you're really trying to drive on Facebook, on Twitter, even on your site, but I'm wondering, what are you guys doing with data? How are you using data to market to your customers better, your viewers better, to learn about them?
Well, we certainly look at what kinds of content resonate with our audience. Does video do well on Facebook? Is it photos? Is it a comment from one of the stars of our show? How are things doing on YouTube? Should we focus more on that? Should we focus more on Twitter? We're also kind of beholden to the larger TV network, which makes a lot of money through on-air ad sales. And so if a producer or the head of our network wants us to devote resources to a show that maybe doesn't do that well on social, we still have to do it, because ultimately our goal is to build ratings on our biggest shows on air, not necessarily focus on what does well online.
So as a follow-up to that then, I would ask, so how are you guys, are you seeing a strong correlation in your social analytics to any upticks in viewing on actual TV station, or, you know, is it causation, correlation, like how do you relate the two?
It's a good question, and it's still a little unclear how much effect what we do online affects ratings. I think generally it does help. Our highest rated show on air is called Hardcore Pawn, and that has a good but not a great online audience. Our show Impractical Jokers has a younger fan base, has a more socially active fan base, and while the ratings aren't quite as high as Hardcore Pawn on air, the online ratings are much huger. So it's really hard to tell exactly what effect what we do has.